I started a little bit skeptical because I know what it takes to make a brain. It's hard. This is the most complex tissue, I would say, no offense to anybody else, but it's a complex tissue. Hundreds of years of an entire field studying how the brain develops, and we're still studying it. But I was amazed at the diversity of cell types that could be made, how certain aspects of development are reproduced. For example, I'll give you an example. In the cerebral cortex, which is the part of the brain we study, the excitatory neurons of the cortex are generated in a specific temporal order, never in random orders. Like first you make one class, then the other class, and so on and so forth. So you build them in order and you build layers. And so aspects of that process, you can see in organoids as well. You first get the cells that are made first during development, then the others, suggesting that within the genome of the cell, which is really mind-blowing, there is all the information you need to make something as complex as the brain. And in an organoid where you can generate many, many different classes, for me, the first step was a characterization step of understanding what cells do we have, how do they look like, how far do they mature, and that forms a hypothesis for what we can do with the system. Something revolutionary is coming, where not only we're beginning to understand them, but we're beginning to think about ways we can use them to really study disease that are much more elaborated compared to what we were thinking about 3 years ago. So better development of the model, better understanding of the system leads to, oh wow, we can now study this, which is so critical for understanding this disease.